their manager was a, you know, a guy who decided he would be a manager one day in November 1961.
From a record store.
That's right. He was coming at the business sideways, and little did they know, so was George Martin, who was a big faker. You know, George was actually born on the wrong side of the tracks. Actually was more impoverished than even Ringo.
Wow.
But he had, during the war, decided to do a little social climbing, and he refashioned his accent, and the rest is history. But they had to win him over, you know, and one of the great stories of the Beatles is how they do that. And it's the song Please Please Me. He sort of scolds them for playing it at a very, what he called, a slow and dreary pace.
Bing Crosby-ish.
That's right. And they amped it up, and George was in, really, from that point forward. He believed in them. He believed that they could change for him and that they would work hard, and man, did they ever.
And he had bought How Do You Do It, right? He had come up with How Do You Do It to be their hit, and they basically topped it with Please Please Me. And, you know, we'll write our own number one hit, right? And that came back, and then when it was over, I'm telling you now, right, but you tell me, you know, basically, all right, you got your number one record, here we go. And that's where it all began. And I get chills to this day when I hear that song.
Sure, and it's a great story. Because first of all, they stood up to him in a very, very risky moment when John Lennon said, "We'd rather have no hit than put that crap out about how to do it." You know, that was a brash thing. They could have been done right there.
Yeah.
George Martin, he liked chutzpah. You know, he liked it when people would put things on the line, and so he challenged them. When they did record it, he did in fact say, you know, you've just recorded your first number one. But thanks to Mark Lewison, who went out and did some amazing research, we now know what the Beatles did next. So when George said that over the talkback, the next thing the Beatles did was just burst out laughing. They thought it was the most ridiculous thing they'd ever heard. There's no way we're going to be number one anything. You know, they didn't even entertain the idea. It seems so ridiculous, you know. And these are the guys who did say we're going to be the toppermost of the poppermost. But, you know, they knew the score. They were coming from Liverpool. It, you know, it helped to have this older guy willing to believe in them and throw his lot in with them.